अभी उसको हाथ मत कर लगाना सेटिंग के, हाँ बस लाइट्स ऊपर का वो लाइट्स नहीं करना, हाँ वो नहीं चालू करना, थैंक यू, कुछ नहीं टच करना, बस ऐसे छोड़ना। हाँ
Now we have here Mukta Aphale. Mukta is a DevOps practice head working with white-age technologies. Almost 13 plus years of solid experience. And Mukta will be talking to us on using Docker for testing. Now Mukta is very passionate about DevOps and ensuring that she has already worked on different technology stacks. She has combined her creativity with the technology to contribute to the fast-paced world of innovation, and she loves to travel, read, and is a mother of two kids. I don't trust it. Anyway, so let's have a big applause, big hand for her.
So, just curious question before we start. How many of you all are no Docker? Is there quite a few? And how many of you are totally new? Like everybody has. And all of you from QA? Who, how many from QA or? So y'all are using Docker for. So we have a lot of QA guys and no Docker. So y'all are using Docker to automate your QA or testing processes here?
We can build ready on different Docker environments.
So Rama actually gave a quick introduction to who I am. But since I've been a developer lately and a DevOps enthusiast since 3 years. I love passion for technology, innovation, and the thirst to keep learning is what drives me. I love to code, design solutions, I love to network. I love to attend conferences, talk there, and I believe in dreaming big, and I believe in work-life balance also. So, and they both are not mutually exclusive. We can dream big and still have a good work-life balance. So, having said, I don't have much of testing background, so why am I at a testing conference? So, typically dev and ops. They say that it's a marriage of development and operations. So where does testing come in picture? Basically, what I believe in DevOps is actually a love triangle between dev, QA, and operations. DevOps actually touches the entire spectrum, right, from development, operations, and QA. And DevOps also actually encourages that all the three and even your managers and whoever is there, everybody should actually love each other and work together to build better solutions. So today we'll go through what are the current testing challenges, what is Docker, how can Docker help in better testing. Then we'll just talk about what are the traditional ways of doing integration testing, how it can be improved, and I'll show you a demo of using Docker for testing. And a demo of integrating that so that it gets coupled with your CI pipeline. This demo I'll show you through video because of some Docker, by the way, requires network connectivity. You need to have internet. So what are the different testing phases? I'm sure you know all of them. So, and a lot more. So broadly classified, this is how what is required. But for every phase of testing, to better, so the idea that we have here is we want to better everything. It's like continuous improvement, or rather, whatever you're doing, in a Hindi term, you'd say, ye dil maange more. You want to continuously keep doing better than what you've been doing right now. So you want to test earlier, you want to test faster, you want to test more often, and whatever you're doing, you want to automate. So anything you're doing twice or more than twice, let's have a script, let's have something in place which will just automate it. So there's something like the testing maturity. So the key differentiator of best DevOps infrastructures, how is testing maturity defined? It's a vital part of DevOps process. and the test orchestration and automation is still a challenge. So what is test orchestration? Any idea? What do you mean by test orchestration? So basically, we need, yeah.
The system which runs the test,
right?
How they talk to each other.
Absolutely. So it's basically your deployment to your testing environment in such a way that you can actually control that environment. You can scale it if needed. You should be able to know if something is down and then what are the problems. Basically, whatever you're testing, you should know if your infrastructure on which you're running and your applications are being are working the way you want. And then the most important thing, you want to verify the changes. So whatever changes are going in your application, can you verify them, and can you verify them fast? You want to test the code changes and you want to check if they integrate each other. So of course there are different components and which are talking to each other. And most important, you want to ensure that the changes don't blow up the product. So since we have what are the pain points of testing? What typically are the problems that you face by testing?
Defects.
So actually that would be a good point. Like, testers should have find a lot of defects. That's how you define a good tester, is it? So what are the in the testing process, what typically is a problem?
Insufficient test time.
Test time, yeah.
Environments.
Absolutely. So yeah?
Environments,
absolutely. Yes, you need to have environments. You have, actually this was a very good point. You have less time and you want to do a lot of testing. And I personally believe of all the different software groups that we have, testers are the ones who are loaded with or the most pressurized. So they are having a lot of work and you are supposed to actually come up. So for example, if there is a bug that comes in production, the testers always question, why couldn't you find it in your environment?
Lack of domain knowledge.
Right. So the test cases that are being written to accommodate the various cases to do better testing are getting more complex. And there are different. So in case of UI testing, again, we come to a specific example with regard to UI testing or maybe Selenium testing. You're testing something and you need to have your application ready and working, and you need to, if you just, one of the components is changing, then you want to ensure that you are testing correctly, or the web server that you're connecting to is right. About Git branching, so this is my interesting case here. I think most of us are aware of what is Git. We use branching so that it helps you better test a particular branch. Typically, there is a, what do you say, a chicken and egg problem kind of a thing. When do you test a branch? After you have merged it or before you have merged it? So you would merge a branch only when the tests have succeeded. But merging also leads to a lot of defects. So after merging also, there should be some kind of test running. How do you actually resolve this problem? How can you continuously keep testing? Environments is another point where you have a lot of different environments. You have a test environment, and then there is also a need to have that environment as close to production as possible. And one of the things is the failed tests actually pollute the environment. So every time you have, actually you must have seen this. As a tester sometimes, you're supposed to test like step one, step two, step three. You decided, no, I'm going to be a very smart guy and I'm going to run step two first and then step one. Let's see what happens. It's valid, right? You're a tester, you're supposed to break. That's your job. So you run step two and the entire environment crashes. The developers come and say, hey, you're not supposed to do that. You're supposed to run step one first. And then the developers are like, no. Now, what is this going to result in? One day of delay of recreating the environment or fixing some broken scripts. Consider that somebody like you goes and is at the client side and he does the same thing. He feels like saying, yeah, I'm going to run step two first. When the client says that, he becomes a god. So you're supposed to, oh, that's a valid scenario now. Now you've got to fix it. How could you do? And then then there are deployment dependencies, testing dependencies, a lot of different components talking to each other. So basically, all of these. So we have this challenge of early frequent testing, accurate testing, and it should be more compliant to the production. And all of these challenges are more or less taken care of by using Docker. Can be resolved using Docker. What is Docker? The service virtualization in the form of containerization, specifically using Docker, intends to solve this problem. What is Docker? It's a Linux container. So basically, it's like a virtualization layer which provides you a space in which you can run your application. But what is the big, trademark, or the key thing why Docker is getting? So this is all that it took to run the five containers as shown in those diagrams. So all it took to run this. Okay, so this architecture was, it was very simple. The containers were up in less than, five containers started in less than a second. You had your entire stuff running and you could just ping and it started serving you. But, so these were the steps. You just have to get clone your repository and do Docker compose build, Docker compose app. Now let's see, you want to run integration tests against this. How would you do that? So example, for this demo purpose, and there is an example of Selenium test written that GitHub path. I've also created a Docker image. If you run that Docker image, it is actually going to run your Selenium test against whatever URL you specify. You can actually customize those Selenium tests because this is a demo. If you want to start, you know, trying your hands on after this session, you can actually, there is a README written there that you can just change those, replace them with your project Selenium tests, and how you can actually Dockerize and make use of. So how you can use it is there in the README. For the demo purpose, I've used headless Selenium tests, but you can actually, Docker also supports running Selenium, running a UI inside a container. There are some additional tweaks that have to be done, but you can run them also. So there will be a link at the end about how you can run properly, say, Chrome Selenium tests using Docker. At the end of the session, there is a link provided. So in case, so right now what we'll see is, as I mentioned, we have the Selenium code. From the code, we can generate a Docker image. So right now what we're going to do is we're going to take the Selenium example headless from the Docker repository and just run it. And it will run against the test URL. By, how will it run? You'll run a Docker run command and you just tell them the test URL is whatever your command is. And then you say, this is the Docker image that you have, please run it. And it will run the test. So this is just a sample output. If you run, so it shows a Docker run dash IP, the command that we saw. And what you just, it's actually running a Selenium test. Something just skipped here. But at the end, it will have two tests running. And it will show a build success or failure or whatever it is. Right now, the tests are test.example or testing unit driver test. So we go through the code. You see how we have containerized the Selenium test. So this is the SRC test example. If you look at this, there are two tests which are written. The first one is actually an irrelevant test for our example, but what it does is it opens up a google.com, it searches for something like Docker. If it finds a Docker in one of the searches examples, it says success. But there is another test that you want to run is actually it takes the environment variable for whatever you want to get. HTML unit driver is a headless Selenium way to run a headless Selenium test. it just goes to that URL and checks if this page has been viewed as one of the page contents. It does it twice and then it says driver.quit. So just these two simple tests which are going to run. For your reference in there are some Chrome and Firefox tests also written, but we want to control which tests we are going to run. So how can we dockerize this? For example, if I want to just run npm verify here, this would simply, this should ideally just, so it failed. Can anybody guess why this has failed? So basically, there was an environment variable that this is using. This URL that it is pointing to is not what we are right now testing on. Let's check what our URL is. Let's set this in. Oh, this is not going to run. Back to the demo. Test URL that it's going to take up from the environment and it's going to run the particular test, check if the page source contains page has been viewed. Okay, here it is. So it is pointing to the right environment, the URL that we want to. Without dockerizing, if you want to run the test, you are going to run the npm verify or the npm test command. So this, these tests, Selenium tests, are being written in Java. So we are going to run it using Maven verify npm test. So if you see, this has actually ended. It's showing build success. How we have actually created a thing, but that is actually going to be a. So we will run the Selenium test using. We ran using npm verify, we are going to run it using Docker container. So there is an image called Millennium example, and it's going to run that Docker run command with the right test URL. You pass it to that. what it is actually doing is it's again running an MVA test, but it is running inside a container. How was all of this possible? There was just a Docker file that was written. I needed Maven, so I took the official Maven repo. I had my Selenium tests available in my local, so the copy command actually copied all the Selenium tests into the Docker container. So it said copy dot my Selenium tests into a path on the Docker container, and it actually installed all the MVM dependencies. And when I'm going to run the container, it's going to run the this command, Maven command. All that I had to do, how do I create it? I do a Docker build that, and then you can call it as my test dot, and it actually builds that image for you. So I'm going to skip this. So it's actually built if I and then you have a Docker image ready. So Docker images, okay. And you have the image ready. But actually, it would make sense if we have all of this integrated as a part of our tightly built. So we want to put it all together and make this a part of your entire CI process. So how would you do it? You can create a Jenkins job, considering Jenkins is one of the most popularly used CI servers available. You create a Jenkins job. You can, over here you can see the test result trends. There are two tests out there. They have been successful for quite some run cycles. That's where you can actually see them. How does the job configuration look like? It shows the repository URL you want to build. So my job is going to build every day at 1 o'clock at night. Then the first build step is, it executes a command shell. So I have actually pushed my build script inside the Git repository. The first few part of 1, 2, 3, they actually remove any applications that are running, it just stops them. Then it does a build and then it just runs, it does an app. Second build steps is when it actually pulls the Selenium examples. Consider that typically users, the developers are working on one repository. And the testing, Selenium tests are written by somebody else, so they are in some other repository who are building this particular Docker image, which is ready for you, the way we checked, we saw in the example. You can create a Docker image for Selenium tests, and then all you have to do is, the next step is you have to run, Docker run. I'd like to mention here, there is a -v command which is mounting the result of the Selenium tests into a particular folder called user share app target surefire reports. This would be used by Jenkins in the post build action to publish your JUnit test report. So there is one step, it just waits for your Docker image, the Docker container to run test, it just stops. So basically with, so we have the Jenkins, I'll just run that video in the background while we have Q&A going on. So this demo about running it in a nightly build. But what after this? So there is actually a lot more you can do if you have to build upon a particular basic, I mean a simple example of using Docker for testing. If you want to go back and build on top of that, what can you do? You can run Selenium tests inside with UI inside Docker. You can use Docker Swarm to deploy. So here, in this demo, we have not used Docker Swarm. What is Docker Swarm? Docker Swarm helps you in deploying to distributed applications. Here, when I ran Docker Compose up without using any Docker Swarm something, it deployed to my local. But I would want to deploy to different machines. So you just have to use a Docker Swarm command. Then there is a Docker machine which can also help you provision different VMs. Consider that. So there was a question somebody had asked me yesterday. A Docker can be used only if you're going to use cloud. So it's not for us. We have everything in our data center. So it's not so. So if you have to consider that you've been given some virtual machines or you have some different ID. So for example, the demo that I gave here, I ran everything on my local. I could run it. I didn't need any cloud. There was a part of the test which is running on EC2. So it also ran on EC2. But you could use Docker machine to create machines, virtual machines, like a virtual box or a VMware instance can be used, can be created using the Docker machine command. So there is actually a lot of features that Docker offer. It actually tackles and solves a lot of different problems. These are the references which you can go through, all of that were useful. And
one or two questions, quick questions. Can Docker help you to go for the data driven tests in virtual scenarios or for virtual testing?
Can you explain?
So you have a messaging, like the service messaging. So can I actually use Docker to automate that for a wide direct set of data? Because I'm seeing here the internally poking there and taking the response within the container.
Help me understand if I've understood your question correctly. So basically you don't have a web server kind of an application. And you have probably something running as a desktop application or something where you don't have...
Actually, scenario is like this. I have application. Has a third, web service interface. Web service interface is not really ready. So I'm trying to use Docker to actually ensure that virtualization is happening.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, so you can.
For a single piece, right. I want to test it for a very set of test data.
Yes, so yes. Yes, absolutely. Yes, you can. You can use Docker. Yes. Right, so the demo that actually I showed in here for this particular session, it was a very simple test. Use case highlighting a web server application, but of course this is not something, you're not going to have a page that shows you have been hit 5 number of times, this page has been viewed 5 number of times or 6 number. So it's going to be a lot more complex, and even if it's a web server, it's going to be a lot more complex, and everything need not, so Docker can be used not just for a web server kind of an application, you can also have it for a desktop application. So one of the questions also somebody had asked me, which I'd like to share in case. So you can run Docker on any Unix or Linux operating systems. You can run it on Mac. You can run it on Windows. But the OS that runs inside your container cannot be a Windows container yet. So if you have your servers on Windows, if there's everything on Windows, that's the only case where right now you cannot use Docker. Otherwise, I don't see any reason. Basically, Docker helps you mainly in the infrastructure automation part and the configurations part. The ease of the redundancy of deploying, then recreating instances, and then redoing it again, and again recreate another instance, and then oh, now my DBs things have been, something has gone wrong, or you want to reproduce some problem. So basically, if you're running your test inside a container or something, there is something like called as a, you take a snapshot of whatever you've done till then, and you save it. Say after a month or something, somebody says that, what had happened at that time? So you have that image with you. You bring it up, try debugging from there. If you have the same application running somewhere and consider something went wrong, and you want to recreate, till then somebody said, no, let's reset it. Then your test cases are gone, you'll have to just jot them down somewhere. What did you actually do? How would you reproduce it?
The virtual machine and the Docker thing. So in case of virtual machine, we partition the same machine it. Let's say I want three virtual machines. Now, in terms of Docker, how should I understand that Docker is also consuming some part of memory?
Right. So, Docker as such is supposed to be very lightweight. So, consider that, like you mentioned, you are running three virtual machines on your. Typically, when you run three virtual machines on your desktop at the same time, your machine is going to be really tired, unless, because you've got something really great work. But typically, two or three is something which would work. But you can actually, right now, if you see, there were five containers running on my machine and it's running very well. So, in general, Docker utilizes your resources to the minimum. But you can tell when you run, there is a Docker run command, you can tell it, look, I want you to use about, say, 10% of you 10% of my CPU, and you want to use so much memory. And after some time, the running container, you want to increase its resources, the host resources. You can do that. By default, it takes the minimum that is required to run that particular container. And every time you run it, it can be different.
Okay, thank you, Mukta. Can I mark it?
Thank you.